Because it's amazing how to see that actually music can travel. And the name of this song is the Voyager song, and it's a longing for home. That's the lyrics. But we're going to play that today as a tune, the Voyager song.
Mine and Daphna's friendship is 1 year old, and we met at the St. Ethelbergas in Liverpool Street last year to perform for a women's music festival. So when we decided to collaborate, I found so many similarities between Indian music and the Balkan music. Example, this Voyager song, it's a very nice tune and very heart-touching tune, and it's Kiravani for us. Finally, for our Indian ears, it's all ragas, and we could find so many similarities. And also one more thing, jazz and Indian music, it gels so well. Jazz is improvisation, and again, Indian music is all about improvisation. And I think this is the fifth program, the fifth concert together. Yeah.
I would like also to take the opportunity of talking about jazz, because apart from us two, there's some wonderful musicians here on stage, and they're all jazz musicians actually. So Mark Bassi, trombone. Stuart Curtis, saxophones and flutes. Chris Nichols, drums. And it's true that there's so much similarity between the styles of music, and that's, I think, the beauty of music, which can be unlike anything else that we have today in the world, politics or you name it, at least one point of light to bring people together. we're going to play now a composition that I actually recorded for a CD called Reconciliation. The CD was released in New York, and the piece called Queen of Sheba. It has elements of both jazz and klezmer and Balkan music.
Thank you.